Come on, let's go.
Good dogs.
Come on out, boys. Let's go, let's go. Let's go. Let's go, let's go. Come on, Bill. Good go. Come on, keep coming. Good boy.
The mosquitoes are very thick. I don't know if it didn't freeze or exactly what happened, but there are plenty of mosquitoes. Hey, Bill.
Good girl.
Mosquitoes all over your face. See you. Yeah, you guys might be kind of miserable.
Bill, where's the trail? Maybe Levi knows. He's too busy taking a pee, though.
Getting you some grasshoppers, Juni? Found the trail. At least I'm pretty sure I found the trail. And there was a breeze, it just went away. Man, it sure was nice. It always takes me a while to find my zen when there's a million mosquitoes. But I can do it. I will find my peace.
Look at this awesome tree.
The beauty.
What is it, Juni?
Don't eat your strings.
Good girl, Juni.
Okay, I think we might be here. This might be the place. Can you see it, Ash? You see it? Oh, this has got to be it. Yeah, I am starting to make peace with these mosquitoes. Oh, this isn't it. Ah. Yeah, they're bugging me too. What a beautiful day. Sure, I'm glad that I'm not letting those mosquitoes bring me down. I can do this. I think this might be the lake. I hope so. No? Nope. Not yet. This is beautiful. Come on, Juni. Juni, come on. Come on. She doesn't like to pass the goats. This has turned into the incredible journey. Tell you what. Oh, I can see it. I don't know if you can or not, but there is blue down there. Okay. The lake is here. We finally made it. Yay! Wow, look at it. It's beautiful. Nice. When you're looking for a place to camp, you have to consider flow both of water and of air. If it rains, water is going to flow. You don't want to be where all the water is draining. Cold air settles to the bottom. So you don't want to choose a spot that's going to be right at the same level as the lake or, you know, something similar, because you will be cold.
Hey, Juni. You want some fish with me? So long as you don't push me into the water. Well, so far, no bites.
I'm going to be cooking on the Firebox Freestyle Tri-Torch. I only brought three of the panels, so I'm going to go ahead and set this up. We want the legs aimed outwards for the most stability. Set up as a Swedish fire torch. I'll just get this fire starter going up here on top, and then I'll kind of break it up and drop it down below. Let's get those carrots in there. I think I'm just going to put the rest of it in and just let it all cook together. Quite a bit of moisture in there. I don't think I want to do all those zucchinis. That's a lot. Maybe not all the mushrooms either. Okay, that fire is really starting to put out quite a bit of heat now. This is perfect for stir fry. Let's just take a look at that fire. Yeah, that looks like that's gonna last. It's gonna be perfect. Ooh, salt and pepper. Let's just make sure we're not burning anything. I don't think we are, because I think that steak is absorbing most of the heat. Kind of regulating the temperature of everything else. Yeah, I think we're fine. Okay, it looks like we're down to just hot coals. So I'm going to drop in a little bit of wood. This will just give us a flame and bring the temperature up. Oh, nice. Okay, we just have those big, beautiful hot coals. Man, they're putting out a lot of heat. So I think that's the perfect temperature for finishing this steak. I don't want to overcook it. In fact, it might be done because these are really nice steaks and they feel soft even when they're fully cooked. Yeah, I think that steak's done. I have some nice sauce that my daughter Isla made for me. Oh yeah, there's still a lot of heat coming off of that. I think we're in great shape. Let's see how this steak looks. I'll save some of this for the dogs. Okay, Juni, here you go. Here you go. Look at that. Let's get some of these veggies up here. Wow. You can see we still have big, beautiful hot coals. Seriously, one of the best camping dinners I have ever had. Good morning. I slept pretty good. At least when I was sleeping. This is the golden hour for mosquitoes. Ugh. I think I'm gonna see if I can catch some fish. It's about 6 a.m. Oh. You can see I have my down booties on, my down pants, my down jacket. The goats are getting frustrated. They're getting eaten alive by mosquitoes. Morning, Ashibu.
Uh-oh, Ash died. You alive? Ash likes to sleep in.
Alright, let's go. Keep him up here. There you go.
Alright, let's go fishing.
Got one.
Nice.
That's awesome. Hoo-hoo-hoo. That's a nice fish.
Beautiful brook trout.
Wow, what a fish.
Wow, look at that beauty, huh?
Woohoo!
Wow.
You weren't ready to brave the cold? You could at least cover up your head, keep those mosquitoes from getting you.
What are you doing, Bill? Oh, yeah. Coffee time.
You okay? Look, I'm so sleepy. What you doing, June?
Let's see what that fire is doing. Oh yeah, so we've just got a nice, you know, kind of medium high temperature. I'm just gonna let those eggs work very slowly. I'm thinking it'll be like meat, where the slower you cook them, the more tender they are. Oh yeah, perfect. Maybe something like that. Time to eat. Let's get a little salt and pepper. Then we have those hot coals that are just keeping everything warm. This is perfect. Nice soft yolks. Wow. Now, even though there are still hot coals in there, what I can do is just use some paper towel to pick it up. All the hot coals will stay there. And then this by itself will cool down really fast. Okay, now that the tri-torch has cooled down, I can go ahead and remove this pin. I'm just going to keep that in my hand, and then I'm going to wipe the outside first. Just get this loose soot off. It comes off real easy. And then I want to just do the same thing over here. I just want to remove what comes off easy and not worry about the stuff that doesn't come off easy. Just like that. Then I can go ahead and bring these parts together, but I want to put this pin in so that everything stays together. I was gonna try to show you how to tie a lure on, or a hook, or whatever it is you're tying. So I go through, then I use my middle finger, and then I pinch the line with my thumb and forefinger. Then I go around this tail 5 times, 6 times. It doesn't really matter. Some people are superstitious about it. Then you run the tail through the loop that your middle finger was in, and then you run the tail through the loop that you just created. Pop that out the other side. Then you put this in your mouth, you get it just a little bit wet, and you bite this with your teeth, and that's how you pull it tight. The line will burn if it's dry. It needs to have some kind of lubrication so it doesn't get hot. I just get it wet, bite the tail, and pull it tight. And then just make sure you got it good and tight. And then bite that tail up. You don't want to bite it right off at the knot. You want to give it just a little teeny tab. Just makes it hold a little better. Just in case that knot slips, it won't come undone. Oh, I can see him following it. You almost got away. Not quite. Yeah. How come Levi was so nice and you're doing so much work? Sheesh, Bill, you make it too much work. Ash, come on, let's go.
Come on, Billy. Come on, Billy boy. Come on, Ash. Keep on moving, boys.
Well, it's hard to go. It's always hard to leave. Such a nice spot as this. But I'll come back. Here's our last look at it. Beautiful lake, just so deep. Makes the color so pretty. Oh, good girl. Wow, look at that tree. That's amazing.
Let's go, Bill. Keep going.
That was one heck of a climb. How you doing, Levi? Made it. Such a beautiful spot. I just had to stop and shoot a clip of this. Levi just pushed me. Levi, you messed up the shot. I didn't notice on the way in that it was all downhill, but I'm sure noticing on the way out that it's all uphill. Oh, there's the trail right there. Well, we made it. Caught a big, beautiful fish, ate some good food, had a good time.